united in that love, as Christ is united with his church. Marriage is given that husband and wife may comfort and help each other, living faithfully together in need as well as in plenty, in sorrow as well as in joy. It's given that with delight and tenderness they may know each other, and through their union may strengthen the union of their hearts all of their lives shared together. Marriage, husband and wife belong to one another. They begin a new life together in community. It's a way of life that all should honour. It must never be undertaken carelessly, lightly or selfishly, but only reverently, responsibly and after serious thought. This is the way of life hallowed by God Aaron and Hayley now begin. They will give their consent to one another. They will join hands and exchange solemn vows. In token of this, they will give and receive a ring. Therefore, on this their wedding day, we pray with them and for them, that strengthened and guided by God, they may fulfill his purpose the whole of their earthly life together. First, I am required to ask if there is anyone here present who knows any lawful cause or impediment why this couple may not be joined in covenant marriage. If you know such cause, you are to declare it now. Aaron, Hayley, the vows that you are about to make are made in the presence of God, who is the judge of all and knows even the secrets of our hearts. Therefore, if either of you knows any reason why you may not lawfully marry, you must declare. So we pray. God our Father, from the beginning you have blessed creation with abundant life. Pour out your blessing now upon Aaron and Hayley. May they be joined in mutual love and companionship, holiness and commitment to one another. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who is alive and waiting in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Going now to stand and sing our first hymn, Morning's Broken.
I move mountains, but if I have no love, I am nothing. I may give away everything I have, and even give up my body to be burnt. But if I have no love, this does me no good. Love is patient and kind. It is not jealous and conceited or proud. Love is not ill-mannered or selfish or irritable. Love does not keep a record of wrongs. Love is not happy with evil, but is happy with the truth. Love never gives up, and its faith, hope, and patience never fails. Love is eternal. There are inspired messages, but they are temporary. There are gifts of speaking in strong tongues, but they will cease. There is knowledge, but it will pass. For our gifts of knowledge and inspired messages are only partial. But when what is perfect comes, then what is partial will disappear. When I was a child, my speech, feelings, and thinkings were all those of a child. Now that I am a man, I have no more use for childish ways. What we see now is like a dim image in a mirror, and we shall see face to face. What I know now is only partial, then it will be complete as God's knowledge of me. Meanwhile, these three remain, faith, hope, and love, and the greatest of these is love.
E. Cummings. I carry your heart with me, I carry it in my heart, I am never without it. Anywhere I go, you go, my dear. And whatever is done by only me is your doing, my darling. I fear no fate, for you are my fate, my truth. I want no world, but beautiful, you are my world, my true. And it is you, whatever a moon has always meant, and whatever a sun will always sing, is you. Here is the deepest secret nobody knows. Here is the root of the root, and the buzz of the buzz, and the sky of the sky of a tree called life, which grows higher than soul can hope or mind can hide. And this is the wonder that's keeping the stars apart. I carry your heart, I carry it in my heart.
And forsaking love, be faithful to her for as long as we both shall live. Hayley, will you take Aaron to be your husband? You love him, comfort him, honour and protect him. Forsaking lovers, be faithful to him, for as long as you both shall live. And will you, family and friends, support and uphold them both in their marriage now and in all the years that are to come? sickness and in health. To love and to cherish.
To death us do
part. According to God's holy law. In the presence of God, I make this vow.
In the presence of God, I make this
vow. Now pray a prayer of blessing over their wedding rings. Heavenly Father, by your blessing, these rings be to Aaron and Hayley a symbol of unending love and faithfulness. Remind them of the vows and the covenants which they have made this day. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Hayley, I give you this as a sign of our marriage. With my body I honour you. All that I am, I give to you. All that I have, I share. Within the love of God.